Everyone, it's Sal, and thank you so much for your patience today waiting for me. I had a bit of a technical glitch, which is actually very synchronistic because it's going to tie in with something I'm going to talk about today. So thank you, universe, that happened. Patience. I'm very excited today to talk about some really exciting topics within tarot that often can cause some confusion. And you might say, why are you saying it's exciting if it causes confusion? It's exciting for me because for me, it's one of the ways that you can nut out the tarot and really understand it more and become familiar with it. So whenever there's a challenge, when you're a student of tarot, with the rather than being like, oh, it's too hard and I hate it and where am I going to find it? And there's 50 different teachers all telling me how to do this differently on YouTube. I like to consider it as a bit of a challenge of going, okay, well, when I figure out what the answer to this is, I'm going to be a much better tarot reader because I will understand the tarot more. And that's what your journey is. And look, I know there's people here in this group who are amazing and who have been doing tarot a long time, like 20, 30 years, and they're still learning. So there's always more to learn. And so challenges that you're having, please don't worry. That's actually just a sign that you're growing and you're learning. And there will always be solutions. So with that, I just thought I'd start. If you are here with me live today, can you just pop your name in there just so I can see the comments and just make sure that everyone can hear and see me? And while you're doing that, I would just like to start by, with so much gratitude, thanking everyone who bought my new course last week. So those of you who don't know, last week I finally launched my new course, Master, I'm saying because I'm finally, it really was meant to be out by Black Friday, a Master Multiple Choice Tarot Readings with More Confidence. And it's designed to help people who are giving multiple choice tarot readings, like you're answering multiple choice questions with the tarot, and being able to do it on a higher level, being able to do it with more detail, being able to do it with more accuracy, but also doing it in ways when you get challenged by this. And so I just want to thank so much the people that took the time to review my course and purchase my course, particularly Dawn Lundberg and Sharon Whittingham and everyone else who took the time this week to review it, because that makes such a difference. Because what reviewing my course does is it actually makes it become a bestseller. And I'm so excited because it became a bestseller in 4 days. And that to me is a record in the 9 years I've been on Udemy. My course has never gone bestseller in 4 days. That was a huge win and I was so grateful. It really made me feel like the 5 months that I put into it and all the delays and all the dramas I had trying to get it out were worth it. And thank you to everyone who in this Facebook and other Facebook groups that I've seen have been complimenting it and saying how much they love it and how much it's helped them. So thank you so much from all my heart for helping it go bestseller. And then it also, about 2 days ago, got the featured spot in the religion and spirituality part of Udemy, which again is incredibly hard to do. It takes about generally 2 to 3 weeks if you do really well on Udemy with it. You might never get to that spot, and I've never gotten there so quick, and I only launched this course literally a week and 1 day ago. So thank you so much. I'm really, really grateful to everyone who has helped support the course and buy it and told me that they love it. Thank you. So I'm actually going to, oh, hello, Emerit. Oh, and also if you are joining me live, if you are joining me on the replay, so if you're watching this as a replay, you'll be watching it on YouTube, do remember to hit the subscribe button so that you always get these when they come through and you don't have to go hunt for them. Hello, Emerit. That's a great name. Marcy from New York. Kunwa, hello. You're from India. Thank you for showing up so early. It must be like 6:30 in the morning over there, although that's the time I get up, but thank you. Chelsea, Laurie, hello from Calgary, Alberta. Canada. I love Canada. And hello, Laziz. Thank you guys so much for showing up. And Sharon, hello from the Gold Coast. Sharon, thank you for your beautiful review. I really appreciate it. So I'm going to start. So what we're going to talk about today is I'm going to talk about and give you a few tips about the multiple choice readings and a few different ways you can use that, even if you haven't enrolled in the course yet and you're just looking for a few different tips. I'm also going to talk about why some cards are contradictory. And this has been a question I've been getting a lot lately. Like, it can be really difficult, especially when you're beginning as a reader, when you do a spread and you go like, oh my God, that doesn't make sense. That's cancelling that card out. So I want to talk a little bit more about why that is. I'm also also going, and how to overcome that. I'm also going to talk about how to make a 45-minute horseshoe spread a 45-minute reading. I had a question on the Q&A board about this recently, and I thought it'd be a really good topic to give you. I've got five different tips that you can use to not spread out or flesh out. We don't want to be sounding like we're ripping off our customers. But because obviously it's just seven cards, and if you're only kind of reading at a dot point level, then it's going to be hard to turn that into 45 minutes. So I'm going to give you some extra tips on how you can do that. And I'm also going to talk about some very, very exciting changes that are coming into the group and that I'm going to be doing from next month, and how you can get involved in that, and just some different ways that you can enjoy these seminars on the different levels. Sorry, I've been drinking coffee all morning. Launch week. Can I apologize to the people who have emailed me and said, why haven't you got back to me about this? Launch weeks for me are crazy. Like, I can do 11-hour days. So if I haven't got back to you and you aren't sent me an email, I do apologize. It's just getting in the course out and then doing all the stuff that goes with getting it out. It's the list ticking off. It can be a bit overwhelming. So I've had a bit of coffee today to get through it. Hello from California. Hello, Heather May from Melbourne, where I was born. Hello. So let's get started with, before I hiccup again, let's get started with talking about multiple choice readings and why so many of you probably have experienced challenges when you have done them before, and the reason that I actually created an entire course out of them. One of the biggest problems with the tarot and being a reader, especially if you're a professional reader, is that people that come to see you for readings don't often understand how the tarot works, like how it functions as a fortune-telling tool, so to speak. And they're really often, oh, hello, Kuhar, and sorry, I can't say that, I missed that name. Hello to my friends that have come in from India. Also, sorry, I forgot to add, if you've got questions for me along the way, do pop them in and I will get to them at the end. Hello, Nadia from Melbourne. Pop them in and I will get to them at the end. So one of the challenges as a reader is that a lot of people that will come and see you won't know the tool. They won't know how it works. They won't know what it like. And they kind of just expect that they can sit in front of you and you are going to present how the next 5 years of their life is going to look, basically. And what you've got to remember about our lives is that there are so many different aspects to our lives. Like, there is health and family and travel, and there is love and career and jobs. And sometimes some of them all cross over, or sometimes some of them are causing problems and tension within each other. So to be able to just say to someone when they come to see you and they've got multiple choices for something, like say, for example, they want to buy a house and they come to see you, and they sit down in front of you and they're like, okay, I've got three houses to choose from, which one should I buy? This is an incredible pressure on a reader. And I know that even in this group, people have been practicing with each other, and someone's contacted me and said, oh, they asked me which house to buy, what should I do? And they're a beginning reader. So A, can I say, please don't ever contact a beginning reader and ask them what house to buy. Like, a house is a 25-year financial commitment. Please do get a professional reading on that. But also, like, the journey that you will have with anything, whether it be buying a house, whether it be choosing who you're going to marry, whether it be where you're going to live for the next 10 years or moving to a country, will never be a black and white journey. And if you take a moment to reflect on every massive decision you have made that has changed your life, there has always been an aspect of the death card in it, because that's what it is when you want to make a decision to change your life. You're actually killing off an old part of yourself. And that can not always be easy. And so doing multiple choice readings can be quite challenging, because we can be looking for the most positive option, but the most positive option can still have its own share of challenges. And sometimes one card, like say you got something like the Star, so buy this house that says the Star, and then your client runs home and buys the house, and then 3 months later the plumbing explodes and they've got to spend $10,000 on the plumbing, and they come trotting back to you and like in indignant outrage saying, how dare you, look what you've done, I bought this house and now I've got to spend 10 grand on the plumbing. But what if the plumber who comes to see you ends up being the person you marry? Or what if, you know, that just you decide to reinvest in something, or what if something happens that was meant to happen as part of that journey? So we all want this really good, easy, one perfect option, but unfortunately our lives are very rarely like that. Unfortunately, our lessons come to us in sometimes not very nice packages. So multiple choice readings, when you're a reader and you've been put in a position to help someone make a dramatic life change like that, it is really important to, for me, try to do a more detailed reading, because that is what is actually required. So if they've got three different choices of three different houses, then do at least a three card spread for each to say, this was what the journey could be looking like if you do this, this, and this. And as I mentioned, so I teach you how to do that in this course. But I also, because I know what a lot of people are going to come back and say to me, what happens if you work on a phone line? Or what happens if someone's only going to pay you for 10 minutes for that kind of thing? So I always will say to my clients, if they're only going to pay me for a 10-minute reading in that sort of short situation, I'd say, look, this is not the kind of question you want to ask in 10 minutes. Like, we need to do a detailed analysis so you can see the full journey. If they're stubborn and they insist, then you say, okay, well, the ball is in your court. I don't think it's the best way to do it, but let's just look, I'll pull a card each, and then I've got all these other strategies that I teach you in this course on how you can eliminate it for them and make it so that you can get to the answer in 10 minutes. But again, always adding, I think you should come back and do a more detailed reading. But for now, this is what the cards are saying. So I really want to encourage you as readers to not feel the pressure to answer questions that are massive life-changing if you don't feel comfortable. That's important. If someone tries to shame you and say, well, you're a psychic, or you shouldn't be able to just do this and know this, just say straight away, look, I might not be the best reader for you. That's not how I roll. I've said that to clients before, and I've said it with a lot of grace and love, not hostility. Just I've said, I don't think I'm the right one for you. Like, that's not really how my gifts work. And, you know, get prepared to say that to people. That's not how my gifts work. But be conscious that when you are doing multiple choice readings, that there are different levels of what is a life-changing reading and which perhaps needs more detail. And what is just a small, like a small thing, like maybe you're moving to a new place for 6 months. Maybe that doesn't need a big reading. Maybe you can just do three or four cards for that. So I explore that in great detail in the course. So I do encourage you, if you are struggling with your multiple choice tarot readings, to sign up for it, because there's lots and lots of information in there. And I also have included charts with you, with like how to answer certain questions and charts on the high versus low, like when you get tricky ones. If you're not in a position right now, budget-wise, to buy a new course, you can always find my courses on sale, by the way, at the end of Tarot Card Success, or on my website. So the last lecture will show you a bonus, and you just click on that, or just go to my Sal Jade website and you can find it there. But if you're thinking right now, I'm not ready for a full course, on my YouTube channel, and I'll post it in the description link here too, I recently just posted one of the lectures from the entire course, which is how to do high versus low when it's tricky. So what I mean by the tricky is, like, what happens if you get all sixes? Like, there's three courses and they're all, so three choices and they're all sixes. What happens if you get three nines? What happens if you get, you know, two of the same, two pages? So I show you how to do that as well. So that can also help if you're thinking, I'm not quite ready to commit to another course yet. You could go and jump on that and just watch that free sample of the course as well. So I'll pop that in the description for you. So I hope that's helped a little bit. If you've always felt a bit confronted by multiple choice readings, remember to have your boundaries up. It is your choice. You do not have to read for anyone if you don't want to read for anyone. It's funny, in my other group, the Psychic Healing Hub, the one I have for people who are in my Build Your Spiritual Healing on a Budget course and my higher level students, someone just wrote a question saying, there's this woman who just keeps trying to force me to read for her, and I can't feel like I can say no. And other people were very supportive and loving and said, look, no one can force you to read. You can always say no. You know, you're not a servant. You are a free person on this earth. So really, you know, if someone's pressuring you to do a multiple choice reading and it feels too advanced for you, please don't do it. Let them know that, you know, like, there's different ways that you can gently suggest that maybe they either do a more detailed reading or do, you know, separate readings and bigger readings as well. So I hope that's helped. Hello, everyone who's jumped on. Hello, Dawn. Again, Dawn, thank you so much for your beautiful review of Master Multiple Choice Readings with Confidence. Thank you. And thank you. Hello to Scott and Elodie. I love that name, Elodie, so much. Such a cute name. Hello, everyone. So now I'm going to talk. So again, if you've got any more questions about multiple choice, please pop them in here. Or any questions about if you think the course is right for you or where you're at in your journey, just pop them in here and I'm really happy to answer them. Now I'm going to talk about contradictory cards, because this is such a huge challenge, especially when you are a beginning reader. Those of you who are in some of my higher level courses, so if you're in my How to Give Career Readings and Life Purpose Readings course or my Love Readings course, I talk a lot more about that in those courses. But I wanted to share with you today how you can deal with the issue when, say, you're doing a seven card spread like the horseshoe, and the cards, they just all seem to be clashing. So there's good and there's bad, and you're like, well, I don't understand. So say, for example, you're getting in a relationship, like a marriage question, you're getting the Ace of Cups as the feeling, the you position, so the fourth position on the horseshoe. But in the hopes and fears, you're getting the Eight of Swords, which is about feeling trapped. And you might be like, I don't understand. They're feeling trapped, but they're also feeling like their heart's opening. And that could be like, and this is how the tarot works. So this is why I love spreads rather than just randomly chucking out cards, because I love that structure and I think that's just my personality. But for me, I connect that and go, okay, so you are feeling like you are ready for new love. Like maybe this marriage isn't making you happy anymore and your heart is opening, or maybe you're interested in someone else, or maybe even you kind of wish there was some new love and romance in your current marriage, but you're feeling trapped that you can't leave. Like maybe that's for financial reasons, or, you know, there could be other, you can pull more cards to ask about why they feel trapped. But maybe, so your heart is opening because maybe you've been watching movies of people in love, or maybe someone, you know, recently got married and they're just so happy and you just feel that, oh, my heart's really opening and I really want to be in a loving relationship, but I'm kind of trapped in this marriage that's making me really unhappy. So that's one example. Another might be looking at the difference between, let's say, the you card and the environment card. Like say, for example, you got in the you card, the hermit, and then in the environment card, you got the three of cups. So the hermit is obviously about feeling a bit alone and feeling a bit lonely, maybe a bit depressed and going into your cave. And the three of cups is in your environment, there's lots of celebrations going on. So you might be like, well, how can that you be feeling lonely when there's all these celebrations going on? And I'm sure those of you out there who have ever experienced depression know that it's very easy to be in a crowd of people, even a crowd of loved ones, and still feel incredibly alone and feel blue. And, you know, so those kind of things, please don't shy away from them. Like, don't feel like, oh, I don't want to say that because they're going to think I'm an idiot, or they're going to feel like I'm not a good tarot reader because I'm, you know, I'm saying on one hand you feel this, but this is happening. So I actually find that they are the most exciting readings. Yes, they are the most challenging, but they will really test your mettle, because you'll be like, why is that cancelling each other out? What's going on? And I talk about that a bit in the How to Read Tarot When You Struggle to Remember the Cards, for those students who struggle to have with memory and remembering how to do the tarot, remembering the card definitions and are looking for quick little ways to just remember them. I talk about how sometimes in a reading, you've got to focus on what the dramatic tension is, like which cards are playing off each other, because that will often be the real source of struggle within your client. And that is where you can really get on board by helping your client point out, well, hey, say for example, you're really looking, your heart wants to open up and you're feeling like you're ready, but you're afraid to leave this current unhappy marriage. So let's talk about that. Let's talk about why that could be making you so miserable. Like why that's appearing as a combined block for you. And so it just when you see the contradictory cards, don't be afraid of them. Just be a little bit like, there's something deeper going on here. Maybe this is actually the real source of what's going on. Is this person feels that they're ready for something new, but they feel trapped and they can't leave. And, you know, that's an internal battle that is actually driving them into misery. And anyone who's ever had those internal battles, and look, the irony is about us getting confused about these contradictory cards is our entire lives are contradictory like this. Like we see this, you watch any Netflix and the hero or the heroine will have a big goal, but on the other hand they have a ghost, so maybe like they want to be, oh, let's say this, use Top Gun. So let's use Top Gun. So, you know, the character of Maverick wants to be, you know, the best in, this is in the first one, not the new one. He wants to be the best in the world, or, you know, at reaching the Top Gun level of getting the prize. I can't remember what it is. I should, I've seen it 20 times, but being the top. And he wants that. But his ghost is the fear about his father's death and what happened to his father, and that's kind of pulling him in other directions and causing him to act not as smart as the Val Kilmer character. The Val Kilmer character is very centered and focused. And so these are just, it's a really crazy example, but how we as humans are, you know, we let our emotions and our feelings can sometimes tear us in a different direction from our goals. And that's why readings will often reflect that. So take a look at that when you're doing a reading for someone, if there's a contradiction. And I'm going to lead into my next answer now about how to make a horseshoe spread last longer, like will last the full 45 minutes. And there's five different ways that I would suggest you do it. And one of them is just a little bit of what I talked about. But the first way is, I do this in my advanced tarot program as well, if you're ever interested in learning how to do this on a higher level. But I like to pull three oracle cards, or even three tarot cards, or even something like the psychic tarot, which is actually quite good for this exercise, before I even do my reading for my client. So before I even start to feel their energy, I like to just do a quick, like if I know they're coming and reading. Now, obviously, if you're on a phone line, this is a bit harder. But if it's obviously a booked 45-minute session, I will do three of the cards before I know anything about them, basically. And I will just be like, okay, what do I need to know about this person right now before they come? And I will start the reading off by talking to them about those three cards. Okay, so I'll start it by that, and then I'll go into the horseshoe. What would you like to ask me today? And then we'll do the horseshoe spread. And that can take, you know, 5 to 6, 7 minutes to do that. I will also, and again, not always, but I will also sometimes channel. And again, I do that in my advanced tarot and psychic business program. I also do it for those students who are in my How to Be Psychic course. There is a lecture in there about how to connect with your guardian angel, and it can be your gods and goddesses. It doesn't have to be an angel, but I do a quick version of that on my client and just tune into their energy, see what messages their guides have got for them, and I will share that with them before I start to do the reading. So that's another way. Now, the third way is to make connections with the cards. Like, the cards they're not meant to be read like three dot points past, three dot points present. They're actually meant to be very fluidly connecting with each other constantly. So you might even start reading the third card first, or, you know, like, it depending on what the question is and depending on your intuition, or the third card might be popping out at you, like, okay, in the near future, but you fear this and your past is this. Like, so connect the cards together. Don't just read them as card one, card two, card three, and continue to connect them. Like, I like to draw back on them even once I've sort of finished. I like to look and go, are there any other connections here? What is the relationship between the environment and their past, for example? Like, why might their environment be like this? Like, what's happened in the past that's connecting their environment? So I like to just make those connections and go deeper with that. I also do like to ask questions, and people often go, oh, that's cheating, that's digging. I actually just love it because I love to build a rapport and know more about what's going on for my client. And I talk a lot about this in my new course too. Context and background will give you a much deeper reading. Like, we can play guessing games and download guessing psychic information, but actually knowing, like, a card can mean something very, very different if there's a different context to the background So asking questions and engaging and saying, does that resonate with you? How do you feel about that? That's also, you know, that's what helps the session also be a longer session as well. Now, I think I had one more, but now I've forgotten it. Oh, yeah, okay. And then the last one, if you've done all that, or if you're not comfortable with some of that, if you're not comfortable channeling, if you're not comfortable with the three card things, what you can do at the end, so you get through and you've done 30 minutes or something, and you can say, is there anything else you would like to ask? And maybe just do a quick three card spread at the end. So that's another way that you can extend the session, or if you feel like, oh my goodness, I went through that so quickly for that person. And don't worry if you go through something quickly. Like, sometimes I've done readings before that were booked for 45 minutes, and I've done the thing and I've just straight away known what was going to go on, and it's so easy and simple to read, like, you know, base jigsaw puzzle reading, and I've been like, oh, what am I going to do for the next 20 minutes? You know, like they've booked this 45 minute session. And so don't worry, like, again, ask them, you know, is there anything else? Would you like to, you know, what have you got planned for, you know, any travels or any, you know, you can ask them, would you like to know anything? If they're asking a love reading, would they like to know more about their career or anything else? So you can do that too as well. That's another way if it seems to go too fast. And again, encourage them to ask questions about the reading and the cards and anything they feel stuck on. So I hope that has helped, my loves, with trying to make sure that your readings are going for 45 minutes if they've been booked, and, you know, not feeling like you're ripping off your clients, but coming up with strategies to deepen them as well. Oh, this last course was kind of amazing. My multiple choice one, thank you. So now I have some very, very exciting news about how we're going to do our beautiful tarot seminars in our group from now on. So this is the last month that I'm going to be doing them like this, where I post a week before and ask you to tag yourself and then I tag you. There's five reasons why. So I'm adding, hey, Francine, hello, Lindsay. I'm adding basically a different element where you can actually watch my live Facebooks into the group on Zoom. So I'm going to be broadcasting through Zoom and through Facebook Live as well. So you can, and that's especially if you're not on Facebook very often and you're like, oh, I want to go log in and find it. Like, you can just click the Zoom link and you can join me live. And again, you'll still get that replay. And what I'm going to do instead of just making a post to say, hi, I'm doing it next week, tag yourself, I'm actually going to create an email list, and you can just sign up for that list and I will always let you know when my next tarot seminar is. So it'll usually be like 10 days before, 7 to 10 days. Hi, it's on this date, these are the dates. If you want the replay, I will send that out to you within 24 hours. And I'm doing this for a number of reasons. I'm not doing this just to harvest your email address and spam you. Like, I swear I will never send anything to you except these tarot seminars. You'll never get any other promotions or anything else. If you have signed up to one of my other lists, you will still get them. But this list, this will only be about our seminars in our group together and me giving you information about it. But I'm doing it for a number of reasons. And the first is, over the years, people have gotten a bit cranky with me when they say, can you tag me? And I go to tag them and I can't tag them. And it would take me an hour to track down Kathy, my assistant, and say, why can't we tag this person? And it turns out that person doesn't know that their settings are on private and they can't be tagged. So rather than waste an hour of my time and Kathy's time, with emails, I can always just let you know whatever's going on as well. Like, for example, today I was having problems getting on, and it wasn't letting me go live. Like, if I can send you an email and say, hey, I'm running 5 minutes late, then you'll know that it's running late, and that will just, you know, keep you up to touch. And if for some reason I can't do it, you'll know. You won't just show up and think, where is she? What's going on? I'm also doing it because Facebook has did something really weird to me last time I did one, where I couldn't download this to upload it to YouTube. And again, it took me 3 or 4 hours to do it. And I'd rather just avoid that kind of drama. It's just easier for me if I can do through Zoom and then save the Zoom recording and turn that into the YouTube one, rather than try to turn this Facebook Live into it. It just got really tricky. And there was me and like 30 other people on this YouTube guy stalking him going, help, we can't do this. How do we do this? And he was frantically trying to figure it out. And it took us all 3 hours to do it. So I didn't want people to miss out because of that technical glitch, and I'm hoping it doesn't happen again this time. But yeah, so the email thing is just going to be an email list. I will pop it in the featured. I will tag everyone and let them know it's happening. Please know I will very rarely use that function where I tag everyone in the group, because I find it very invasive personally. I'll only use it when I'm letting you know something incredibly important and changing like that in the group. So I'll let everyone know, and look, you don't have to obviously sign up. I'm still going to be here and I'll still be, you know, posting and letting people know, but I just won't be doing this retag stuff because it just is too chaotic. Yes. And also, as I said, that option to be on Zoom is actually quite powerful, because then you can watch it and engage with me and question on Zoom as well, which is also quite cool. So I'll let you guys know more about that. That should be happening in the next 2 weeks. And I'll tag everyone and let them know. And you can, and again, it's voluntary to sign up. You don't have to. I'll still be appearing live here in the group. And if you are on my YouTube, you'll still get these notifications on YouTube when I do one as well. So if you're thinking, I don't know if I want to sign up to an email, I get 90,000 already. So as long as you're checking in with your YouTube regularly, they're still going to go up on YouTube as well. Okay. I'm going to start answer. I hope that's helped everyone. Kunwa, great question. Will you also be posting a reminder on the group 24 hours before the seminar? Yes, absolutely. I'll still be doing that. However, if someone says please tag me, I'm not going to be tagging anyone. So I'm not going to do that anymore. But I will be letting people know that I will be appearing live in the group. That's definitely happening. And I'll just be having a link that says if you want to receive notifications, then just sign up to that. It's just you won't be getting those notifications through Facebook anymore. And look, and the final reason for that, so those of you who did my Grow Your Online Tarot Business webinar last year in December will probably remember how I was talking about the Facebook algorithm is just making it incredibly difficult for creators, content creators like me, to reach our audience that are in your group. Even though you're in my group, it's still hard for me to let you know that things are going on. Whereas with email, it's like I can just send it out and you can see it. And again, if you get over it, you can just unsubscribe. So on that note, sorry, I will be running another one of those, the Grow Your Online Tarot webinar. Get it right, Sal. Grow Your Online Tarot Business. So another webinar on Zoom, like I did last year in December. I will be running another one of them. I'm hoping it's next month in April, my birthday month, but my birthday month can get a bit chaotic, but I'm hoping that it will be that month. So I will keep everyone posted on that as well. So I hope that's helped everyone, and I'm looking forward to this new format. As I said, you'll have the choice to either see me on Zoom, on YouTube, or see me here. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to pop them in here. I can't see any here. Sometimes I miss them. And if you have asked me a question I've missed, I'm sorry. But yes, I'll be here for another couple of minutes if you want to ask anything. I can't think of anything else I need to talk to you guys all about, other than I hope your year is going really well so far. And again, thank you to everyone who's been supporting the new course and that it went bestseller. And thank you so much for that. I really appreciate it. And I hope this has helped you with your tarot journey today. And if you've got any further follow-up questions, I'll be around today for another couple of hours, checking in and uploading things to YouTube. If you are on the replay, just put hashtag replay so I know that you're obviously not joining me live. Okay, have an awesome weekend, everyone. Bye.